Hi, Tracy here from Nature's Heart. Today I want to talk about a little bit of a different topic, a little bit heavier than previous topics. I want to talk about grief. And grief is one of those emotions that is not talked about in our North American culture. It is something that is, you know, we don't talk about death, we don't deal with death. So grief coming out of death, it's also something that we don't talk about. And I didn't really realize that until I started in my earth medicine studies. And in earth medicine school, we look at a lot of shamanic practices. And the First Nations people have a completely different way of looking at death as a part of life. And it got me thinking too how my ancestors also were that way. They were connected to the earth, you know, the ancient Celtic people. We're connected to the earth and the cycles of the earth, and they believed that from death came life. And we see that now in the Northern Hemisphere. We're in autumn. The leaves are falling off the tree, and they're composting on the ground, and they're feeding the soil. And it's nourishing the soil, and from that we get new life. So it got me thinking to how could I adapt this into my way of thinking and my way of being. How could I be okay with grief as an emotion that I can feel? 2 years ago, my mom passed away, and my mom was my best friend. So it was, hi Jill, thanks for joining us. Me. Us, I don't know why I say us. And it was really, really difficult for me. It was something that I didn't know how to grieve. And I was recommended books, you know, this one, Elizabeth Kubler-Ross is one of the primary experts on death and grieving. And I realized that I didn't know how to grieve. I didn't know how to allow myself to feel sad. And when I started earth medicine school studies about a year ago, I realized that in the cycle of the seasons, is the natural connection to death. And in allowing myself to be okay with that, thanks Jill, allowing myself to be okay with that was a really important step. It's taken me 2 years, and I have been offline for a little while dealing with my own grief. And my experience I wanted to share because I think it's important that we acknowledge that death is a part of life and grieving is a natural process for us and not something to be afraid of, which is how I was approaching it. And even until about a month ago, I was still turning away from what I anticipated to be this really big, I called it this big ball of griefs. And when I allowed myself to actually look at it and unravel it, and the phrases sit with it, and I didn't really know what that meant. It means don't be busy. Don't make yourself so busy that you can't allow yourself to feel sad. You can't allow yourself the time to do what you need to do to work through this loss. Now, in my case, it was a death of a beloved family member. Grief comes in many forms. It could be the end of a relationship. It could be the end of a role in your life. You know, a job, or for women who are mothers, that empty nest situation. Those are all griefs, and they're things that we need to give ourselves the time to process and work through. So that was what I did. I allowed myself the time to work through a number of transitions, and it actually was not as bad as I imagined it was going to be. I had worked it up into this big giant thing, and once I allowed myself to look at it and feel what I was feeling and allow myself to be okay with how I was feeling, even though they weren't the happy, joyful emotions that I like to put out there, it was okay. And it actually gave me a really good insight and an important insight into how important grief is. And in honoring my feelings and in honoring my grief, I was actually honoring my mother, and I was honoring that part of myself that I had not allowed myself to feel. So that's my experience around grief, and I think it's something that our culture could really, we can learn a lot from ancient earth-based cultures who look at death as a part of life, and I think that's something that we can really learn from. Another thing that I found important was to show my son that it was okay to feel sad and it was okay to grieve. And I'm reminded of that this week. We had a death of a young man in our community, a young man who my son called a friend. And it's brought up some really difficult emotions for him. And young people, because they don't see us grieving or acknowledging our sadness and our feelings of loss, they don't learn how to do that. And that was really brought home to me this week. So my invitation for you today is to consider grief and how you look at grief, and if you allow yourself to honor these feelings of sadness and loss, and how you can do that. Lots of supports out there, you know, contact a trusted advisor or friend, counselors, coaches. There are a lot of resources. It is something that, because it's not ingrained in our culture, it is something that's a little bit more challenging to look at on your own. And it is so important. So that is my invitation for you today, to consider grief and how it shows up for you and how you can honor that as part of life. Thanks for joining me, and I wish you a lovely day.